Hello learners, we'll be doing unit 9, that is nutritional monitoring and surveillance. This chapter deals with the procedures and policies which are taken for rectifying or finding out why and also determining what is the nutritional status and finding out if there is any problem and solving it. And as the name is suggesting, it is a surveillance procedure. So what is nutritional monitoring? Monitoring literally means to supervise or to keep an eye on or to scrutinize. Okay. Monitoring refers to the collection, analysis and feedback quantitative precise measures from a relatively large representative sample of a population at the national and state levels, essentially for the purpose of tracking time trends and understanding population subgroup differences in diet, nutritional status and nutrition related health and disease risks. Nutrition monitoring is a tool to keep a watch on the nutritional status of communities to assess the changes in nutritional status of communities over a period of time. Who defines nutrition monitoring as the measurement of changes over time in the nutritional status of a population or a specific group of individuals? A detailed appraisal of an intervention program by examining the processes of implementation and outcome variables to determine as to how far the program goals can be achieved, and if not, then reasons for non-achievement of goals is the nutrition evaluation. The aims and objectives and components are given, which need not be explained. So go through it. And there are certain organizations who look into the matter. Four organizations are National Nutrition Monitoring Bureau, which is there in Kolkata also. National Sample Survey Organization, National Family Health Survey, and District Level Household Survey, that is RCH. The objectives and everything are given over here, so you learn that. Now coming to nutritional surveillance system. Nutrition surveillance means watching over nutrition in order to make decisions which will lead to improvement of nutritional status of population. Nutritional surveillance is a continuous and systematic process of collection, analysis, interpretation of information to assess nutritional status and initiate appropriate early action to promote optimal nutrition. Surveillance, on the contrary, is considered with data on current status or activities at local levels for initiating action in response to events occurring during specific program implementation in the population. Even nutritional surveillance has some objectives and uses. You have to go through that and the indicators also. So this chapter basically deals with this. Now coming to unit 10, that is nutrition policies and programs. So there are various intervention programs and policies taken up by the government when certain deficiency or certain nutritional issue happens to a community, or maybe is a very common thing. Some kinds of nutritional intervention programs are taken by the government and those are passed by the government so that it is mandatory for everyone to follow. So we need not explain this much. There are many programs by the ICDS, and even the supplementary program is also a nutritional intervention program. Immunization, health checkup, these all are mandatory for everyone, and this is done by the government because of these kind to basically prevent these kind of nutritional deficiency disorders or maybe any type of health disorders. Three programs are mentioned and in detail, and go through them. First one is National Prophylaxis Program for Prevention of Blindness Due to Vitamin E Deficiency. The second one is Nutritional Anemia Control Program, and the third one is National Iodine Deficiency Disorder Control Program. As these three things were common in a point of time in our past, so that's why these all intervention programs were taken, so that it is mandatory and people do not suffer from vitamin A or iodine or iron or folic acid, these kind of things, so that these type of programs are taken and you can go through them. Now coming to supplementary feeding programs, the same way there are many supplementary feeding programs which are being taken so that malnourishment can be reduced. One is National Program of Nutritional Support to Primary Education, that is midday meal, which we normally see in government schools. There is a midday meal thing program going on from like maybe many years. This is done for two reasons. One is the nutritional status of the kid can be assessed if one part of time, basically the lunch is given by them, so that they are sure enough that the baby or the infant or the kid is getting appropriate amount of nutrition at least in a meal. And that is actually excess, that happens to be actually excess, because it is assumed that in the rest of the two main meals, that is breakfast and dinner, they are always deficient of whatever nutritional interventions needed. So a bit of extra is given in the lunch. Next we come to special nutrition program. This was launched by the Central Social Welfare for Children, Pregnant Women and Nursing Mothers, for again to give ample amount of nutrition to them. Next comes the Pradhan Mantri Gramodaya Yojana, then Balwadi Feeding Program, the Composite Nutrition Program and Applied Nutrition Program. So you go through these all types of supplementary feeding programs so that you can come to know what the government is doing for us for looking after our nutritional status and deficiency disorders, and to cure the deficiency disorder. Now coming to food security programs. One thing which is very common is the PDS and the TPDS system, which is everyone should be knowing Fair Price Shop or the ration shops in every locality. Basically, from this comes under the PDS or the TPDS program, which means everybody is entitled to have certain amount of food, raw materials of the staple food, so that in a low cost, so that that person is able to buy it and eat it, and the nutritional need is fulfilled. Again, a person who is having more and more of money can always afford to buy more things, but this is all for every person, starting from a person who is below poverty line or a person who is having low income, is from low income group, to a person who is from a high income group. Nowadays the policies have changed a bit, which is not mentioned in the book. That is BPL, person who is below poverty line, are entitled for more raw materials than ones who is above the poverty line. And even there is a economic weaker EWC category, which is EWS category, which is economically weaker category, who are above the poverty line, but they are not much well off to buy everything. So this way, they based on their Aadhaar and ration card, they are provided with rice, dal or basic amenities so that they can fulfill their stomach and their nutritional needs. So this entire thing comes under PDS and TPDS system, that is public distribution system or targeted public distribution system. Why targeted? Which is targeted because, as I have told earlier, it is for the persons who are below the poverty line, and the PDS system is for all who are below and above both. So based on this, there are certain programs for, as told, one is PDS TPDS system, another is Antodaya Anna Yojana, then Annapurna scheme. These all are for you, like people of India, so that they can avail the appropriate amount of nutrition. Then comes the National Food and Work Program. One more thing. Okay, now coming to the employment status. See, this is very much important to know the employment status, because if the person is earning based on that, the nutrition of that family depends. So there are very many families who are not earning. So for them, government has some schemes and yojanas like Sampurna Gramin Rozgar Yojana, Swarna Jayanti Gram Swarozgar Yojana, and many are there. These two are given in your book, and you have to go through it. And if you go through it, it is very easy. It is nothing. There is nothing to explain. Please go through it, and if you find any doubt, please come up to me. I will explain it to you. Now continuing to Unit 11, which deals with review of national nutrition programs. This chapter deals with many other nutritional programs, as I was mentioning in the previous one. So go through again. There is nothing to explain. So go through it. It deals with National Iodine Deficiency Disorder Control Program, National Anemia Control Program, National Program for Prevention of Nutritional Blindness Due to Vitamin A Deficiency, ICDS, that is Integrated Child Development Services, Pradhan Mantri Gramodaya Yojana, Setbacks and New Challenges, National Programs of Nutritional Support to Primary Education, Employment Generation Schemes, PDS and TPDS System. Okay. And this way, the entire chapter is dealing with these type of programs, and go through it.